आमचा चॅनल सबस्क्राइब करा आणि बेल आयकॉनवर क्लिक करून नवीन नवीन व्हिडिओचे नोटिफिकेशन्स मिळवा.
हॅलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल ऑफ यू. वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट अँड यूजफुल लेसन. थिंक बिफोर यू स्पीक. इट्स नॉट ओनली लिमिटेड टू युअर 9th स्टँडर्ड स्टडी ऑर सिलेबस, बट इट इज व्हेरी यूजफुल टू युअर होल लाईफ फॉर एवर. आर यू इवर थिंक अबाउट हाऊ अँड वॉट यू स्पीक इन युअर डे टू डे लाईफ? आय थिंक ॲब्सुलेटली नॉट, बिकॉज यू कांट कॉन्सन्ट्रेट ऑन हाऊ अँड वॉट यू स्पीक विथ युअर रिलेटिव्ज, with your friends, with your family members, etc. Because whenever we speak, we can't concentrate on the words, their meanings, their effect, because unspoken words or unspoken word, you have the master of that word. But whenever you utter a word, the spoken word, you become a slave. And it's a fact. One of the British statesmen here prove this fact by giving one example here, because he thought that thinking is very important. He focus on, concentrate on thinking, because we can't think which, what and how we speak with our surrounding people, and it's a fact. And in through this lesson he wanted to give a very good message to all of you, because think before you speak. Think twicely, thricely before you speaking, you utter a word here. Because unspoken words you have, you are the master of that word. But suppose you speak some words, some thoughts, some speech, talk, etc. You become a slave of that word, that thought, that concept. And so you have to be remember always that unspoken words you are the master, and spoken words you become a slave in that word. And this lesson, through this lesson we wanted to see how this became true in our whole life. Man was meant to listen more and talk less. It's a very good example, good thought he has given here, because man was meant to listen more and talk less. That is why as a great British statesman Benjamin Disraeli, you know the name of that, he was a very famous British statesman, and he has given the fact here why it is like that. Man was meant to listen more opposite to talk less. You have to be listen more and more things carefully, consciously, and speak very less. And this fact he has given one of the very good example here. He has given a comment here, Benjamin Disraeli, one of the famous British statesmen here. He has given one of the very good comment. Nature has endowed man with 2 ears. We have 2 ears and only 1 mouth. Why it is? There is not a, is there any biological reason about that? He has not going through that biological reason here, but he has only proved the fact here. Which is the fact of that? That is, nature has endowed. You have to be remember that endowed means here it is provided permanently as a gift. Endowed means provided permanently as a gift. It is given by God. We have get 2 ears and only 1 mouth. Why is it like that? What is the meaning of that? That fact. It is, if man was meant to talk more and listen less, he would have 2 mouths and only 1 ear. Because the God thinking about man's activities, he says that you have to be listen more and more opposite to talk less, very less you have to be talk. And if he wanted to give you the message that you have to be talk more and more, we all people done like this way. We talking more and more words, more and more speak, more and more talk, etc. without thinking that we have to be listen. which what are the in front of the people, in front of the person telling to you. We can't concentrate, we can't listen that person's talk or speech. Opposite to that, we are thinking about, we are speaking in a flow more and more. If man was meant to talk more and more and listen very less, he would have two mouths. If you, God has wanted to speak more and more, opposite to listen very less, we have two mouths and only one ear at the center. How strange it is, imagine that, how you are looking in that situation. How strange it is, you have two mouths and only one ear at the center. Are you imagining yourself, your personality in that position, in that situation? How strange it is. And so imagine how we have looked at that situation. How strange, with two mouths on the two sides and only one ear at the center. And so in the very first paragraph, here author has given a very important lesson, important message, that man is meant only to listen more than talk less. You have to be listen more and more things. The person in front of you has talking with you a lot of things. You have to be listen it very carefully, very consciously. And we can't concentrate our day-to-day life also. We can't concentrate our talk, our speech, our speak, how we speak and what we speak with our friends, our relatives, their meaning, their effect. And so we are in a big trouble afterwards, because the quarrels are there. Why? Because we are not thinking about what and how we speak. What is the meaning of that word? How it affects in front of the person's mind, his heart, his or her heart. How it affects, directly affects. Your words are directly affected the mind of that person, the heart of that person. And it should be, he or she should be very upset afterwards. And you are in a big trouble. And so this important message the writer has given here in the first paragraph. We always speaking with our friends, our relatives, more and more without thinking, without listening that person's. And so we are in a big trouble. So here in the second paragraph, and mind you, the ears are like funnels. The Benjamin Disraeli here has said that, and mind you, the ears are like funnels. Funnels means here the vessel ear, cone-shaped vessel. It is here, funnels means cone-shaped vessel or tube. It is used in our science experiments also. And our ears, it is not closed. There is not any door, any window to close your ears. And it is like a funnels, open all the time. Is it shut down in the night time, or when you are not listening at that time, you are close your ears, there is any window, any door in your ear? Not. It is not like that, because it is always open. At any moment, at the night time, at the afternoon time, day time, you have to be listen more and more. What is the meaning of that? Your ears are like funnels, open all the time. There is not any door, not any window to close your ears. What is the meaning of that? You have to be listen more and more. Without speaking more and more, you have to be listen more and more. And very less, you have to be speak. There is no door with which you can close them. Whereas if you have to speak even one single word, that word must pass through two walls. If suppose you wanted to speak with someone, at that time your word should be if you wanted to speak even one single word, that word must pass through two walls. There is two walls. If you wanted to speak some person with another person, your words should have passed through two walls. Which are these two walls? First wall is It is called also fences. Fences, you know that compound. You have to be make compound in your garden, etc. And like that way, your word pass through two walls. First one is, there is firstly the fence of these two rows of teeth. Two rows of teeth. It is the first fence. And second one, two lips. We have, when we utter a word, we speak with another person. Our words should pass through these two walls, two fences. First, there is first one is two rows of our teeth, and secondly the fence of two lips. Means we have to be think. What is the meaning of that? We think consciously, silently. If you have hungry, there is a lot of situations in our life also. We are in a happy mood, we are in an angry mood, etc. But when we are angry, we have to be count 1 to 10 numbers at that time, because it get you some time to speak. You have get some time to think over that word, think over that situation. And so it is very good method how to be count 1 to 10 numbers, etc. You get some space, some time to think in that situation. And here, before a word can be spoken, it has to pierce through these two walls, through these two fences. And it is a very important here thought he has given, the writer has given here. You have, before you utter a word, before you speak, you have to be passed through from these two fences. First one, two rows of your teeth, and second one is here, the fence of your two lips. And through that you have to be utter a word, or you have begin to speak here. कमीत कमी बोलावं आणि जास्तीत जास्त इतरांचं ऐकावं, आणि तेही अतिशय काळजीपूर्वक, लक्षपूर्वक. असं जर नसतं तर आपल्याला एका तोंडाऐवजी दोन तोंडं देवानं दिली असती, आणि एकच कान सेंटरला, केंद्रबिंदूस्थानी दिला असता. विचार करा, कल्पना करा, कसं दिसलं असतं आपण? आपल्याला जर दोन तोंडे आणि एकच कान असता तर कसं दिसलं असतं आपण? कल्पना करा, स्वतःला बघा. हाऊ स्ट्रेंज, किती विचित्र आपण दिसलो असतो, बरोबर? तर याचा अर्थ असा होतो की तुम्ही अधिकतर इतरांचं ऐकलं पाहिजे आणि कमीत कमी बोललं पाहिजे. पण आपण दररोजच्या दैनंदिन जीवनामध्ये बघितलं तर काय करतो? बरोबर याच्या विरुद्ध करायला जातो. आपण जास्तीत जास्त बोलत जातो, पुढच्या व्यक्तीचं काहीही न ऐकता. एकदा आपण त्या फ्लोमध्ये, प्रवाहामध्ये बोलत गेलो तर पुढच्या व्यक्तीचं ऐकूनच घेत नाही. काय परिणाम होतो त्याचा? तर आपण बोलल्यानंतर आपणच एका मोठ्या संकटामध्ये येऊ शकतो. का बरं? कारण एकदा आपण बोललेला शब्द पुन्हा माघारी घेता येत नाही. अतिशय महत्त्वाचा इथं संदेश लेखकानं दिला आहे की एकदा आपण उच्चारलेला शब्द पुन्हा परत घेता येत नाही. आणि म्हणून आपण बोलण्यापूर्वी काळजीपूर्वक विचार करून तो शब्द उच्चारला पाहिजे, बोललं पाहिजे. किमान दोन वेळा तरी आपण काय बोलतोय याचा विचार करून पुढच्या व्यक्तीला बोललं पाहिजे. आणि लक्षात घ्या, आपले कान कसे आहेत? एखाद्या नरसाळ्यासारखे. त्याला काही खिडक्या, दारं आहेत का बंद करायला? रात्रीच्या वेळी आपण बंद करून झोपलं, झालं असं काय आहे का? नाही. तर आपले कान बघितला तर एखाद्या नरसाळ्यासारखे आहेत, कायम उघडेच आहेत. तुम्ही ते बंद करू शकत नाही, त्यांना कोणत्याही पद्धतीचं दार नसते. आणि म्हणून उलट तुम्हाला एक शब्द जरी उच्चारायचा असेल तरी त्याला दोन कुंपणातून बाहेर जावं लागतं. ती कुंपणं कोणती आहेत? तर पहिलं कुंपण म्हणजे दोन तुमच्या ज्या दातांच्या ओळ्या आहेत त्यामधून त्याला, त्या शब्दाला किंवा तुमच्या विचाराला, तुमच्या बोलण्याला बाहेर पडावं लागतं. पहिलं ते भेदून ही दोन भिंती आहेत. त्यातली पहिली भिंत म्हणजे दोन तुमच्या दातांच्या ओळी. त्या ओळी भेदूनच तुमचा शब्द उच्चारला जातो, किंवा त्याला भेदूनच पुढं त्या शब्दाला बाहेर पडावं लागतं. आणि त्यानंतर दुसरा कुंपण कुठला असेल तर तुमचे दोन ओठ. त्या ओठामधून त्या शब्दाला बाहेर यावं लागतं. म्हणजे ह्या दोन भिंतींना भेदून तुमचा शब्द बाहेर येतो. याचा अर्थ असा की किमान 2 ते 3 वेळा तुम्ही कोणताही शब्द उच्चारण्यापूर्वी, कोणताही शब्द वाक्य उच्चारण्यापूर्वी, बोलण्यापूर्वी तुम्ही किमान 2 वेळा तरी 3 वेळा तरी त्याबद्दल विचार करणं अतिशय गरजेचं. आणि हाच अतिशय महत्त्वाचा मेसेज बेंजामिन डिझ्रायलीनं पण दिलेला आहे. त्यानं फॅक्ट, एक वास्तव त्यांनी सांगण्याचा प्रयत्न केलेला आहे. आणि त्यासाठी आपल्या शरीराची ठेवण काय आहे याकडे तुम्ही लक्ष द्या. त्याचा त्यांनी इथं अतिशय महत्त्वपूर्ण पद्धतीने उदाहरणासाठी त्यांना वापर केलेला आहे. आणि तुम्हीसुद्धा दररोजच्या दैनंदिन जीवनामध्ये बोलत असताना अतिशय काळजीपूर्वक शब्दांचा उपयोग केला पाहिजे, अतिशय लक्षपूर्वक. खूप महत्त्वाचं आहे. तुमच्या आत्ता फक्त 9वीच्या सिलॅबससाठी हे महत्त्वाचं असतं आहे असं नाही, तर त्याचा वापर तुम्हाला तुमच्या पूर्ण आयुष्यभरासाठी याचा वापर तुम्हाला या लेसनचा होणार आहे. कारण तुम्ही जेव्हा बोलत असता तेव्हा तुम्ही विचारच करत नाही की आपण काय बोलतो, कुणाशी कसं बोलतो, त्या वाक्यांचा परिणाम, त्या शब्दांचा परिणाम त्या व्यक्तीवर, पुढच्या व्यक्तीवर काय होईल याचा तुम्ही कधी विचार करताय? नाही करत. आणि त्याचा परिणाम काय होतो? मग तुम्हीच नंतर खूप मोठ्या संकटामध्ये येण्याची शक्यता असते. म्हणून कधीही तुम्ही बोलत असताना अतिशय महत्त्वाचं म्हणजे तुम्ही विचार करून कोणताही शब्द उच्चारला पाहिजे. कारण बोललेल्या शब्दा, न बोललेल्या शब्दाचे तुम्ही मालक असता. तुम्ही काही बोलू शकता नंतर, न बोललेल्या, न उच्चारलेल्या शब्दाचे तुम्ही मालक असता. पण एकदा का शब्द उच्चारला की त्याचे तुम्ही गुलाम बनता. तो शब्द तुम्हाला पाळावाच लागतो कोणत्याही परिस्थितीत. आणि हीच फॅक्ट तर सांगण्याचा प्रयत्न अतिशय सुंदर पद्धतीनं इथं रायटरनी, या लेखकानं केलेला आहे. थँक्यू ऑल ऑफ यू.